This is pages 4 and 5 of our last piece of Algebra 2, 1132. More about matrices. And this particular lesson is about multiplying them. Now I will show you down here at the bottom of page 4. If we are just multiplying one number out front times the matrix, piece of cake, all right? You just multiply 3 times all 4 numbers. And that becomes the 4 new corners. So these 4 problems appear very easy. Just take the outside number times whatever number that is, leave the answer in a matrix. But we need to talk about, and these are all 4x4s, or 2x2s rather, two rows, two columns. And I want to show you a method that I found that I think, at least it's helping me to visualize it a little better. So, and I'm actually trying to redo this one that we have at the bottom of the page down here. So we have 2, 3, negative 1, 4, negative 1, 0, 4, 5. They're being multiplied, but what I'm doing is I'm writing this one a little bit higher and then this one down here. And then I'm taking this top row and treating it like it's a train, okay? So little cars here. And then they're connected and they come down, boom, in front of this matrix here. Then we're gonna take 2 times the first one, negative 1, plus 3 times 4. That's the upper left-hand corner, okay? Now keeping the same train car here, we're gonna do the top over there. So we're taking the top from here and we're gonna get the 2 top numbers here. So we're gonna do 2 and 3 again, this time times 0, 2 times 0, 3 times 5. All right, now I'm gonna take the bottom one here and turn this into a little train and it's gonna drop in, so negative 1, 4. So to get this one down here, we're gonna take negative 1 times negative 1 plus 4 times 4. This corner over here, we're gonna do negative 1 times 0 plus 4 times 5. All right, so let's see what we get. Negative 2 plus 12. Negative 2 plus 12 would be 10, right? This would be positive 1. 1 times 1 is 1. Plus 16 would be 17. Up here, 2 times 0 is 0. Plus would be 15. And then down here I have 0 plus 20. All right. We'll just double check and see if that's what they got. Oh, look! What's the answer they got? 10, 17, 15, and 20. So let's walk through that again. Because like I said, the math is not hard. You're just multiplying and then you're adding and you're getting an answer. And don't worry if your brain says, I don't understand. There's really nothing to understand, okay? It's treat it more like a game. It's like a puzzle, okay? You just follow the steps of the puzzle and you will get the right answer. So we have this matrix up here. We take the top row, 2, 3, zoom, bring it down in front of the second one. When we do this times this, and then this times this, so that before it was 2 and 3, so 2 times -1, 3 times 4, that goes in the upper corner. Keep it there and do it times the second row, and that's what goes up here. Then we take the bottom row, zoom, bring it down. Multiply it times the first one, that goes in the lower corner, times the second one, goes in the right. Okay? And then you just solve the math for each corner. That part's easy. We just put a matrix around that. Ta-da! All right, like I said, do the math here on page 5. And then there's 12 problems there. And then check your work and make sure But you know what you're doing. If you get any wrong, you can look at the solution manual in the score key and see where you made your mistake. So I would definitely show my work if I were you. I would write all of this out. Don't try to do it in your head. Show it in your on a separate sheet of paper, and then when you score it, you can see where you made a mistake, if you make a mistake.